Hello everyone, welcome to video lecture series of Communication Engineering. Today's topic is FM demodulation. So there are various techniques of FM demodulation. In this video, I am going to talk about the ratio detector. Let us begin. First, let us talk about the demodulation of FM waves. See, demodulation process of FM waves, this is exactly opposite to the operation of the frequency modulation. And FM demodulator, it operates entirely on different principle if you compare with the AM detector. AM detector or demodulators, those are basically a rectifier. But FM demodulator is basically a frequency to amplitude converter. Here frequency variations are converted into the amplitude variations. So this is how you have to understand it. There are two types of FM demodulators. One is the direct type and other is the indirect type. In direct type also there are two categories. One is the frequency discriminator, other is the zero crossing detector. And the indirect type of FM demodulator is phase locked loop. Now there are some special requirements of FM demodulators or detectors. So whenever there is a designing of demodulator or detector circuit, it must satisfy some requirements which is mandatory, which is the necessary conditions. First is the FM demodulator or detector must convert frequency variations into the amplitude variations, and this conversion must be linear, conversion must be efficient. Demodulator circuit must be insensitive to amplitude changes. Insensitive to amplitude changes means demodulator circuit must respond for frequency variations only. It does not respond for any amplitude changes. And the operation and adjustment of the demodulator or detector circuit, it must be easy. It must not be very much critical. So these are the essential requirements for the demodulation of the FM waves, which is required one. Now let us talk about the ratio detector. As I have told you that ratio detector is another form of the frequency demodulator circuit. It is commonly used in radio receivers for demodulating frequency modulated signals. And radio detector, it is a variant of Foster-Seeley discriminator. In the previous video, I have discussed about the phase discriminator or Foster-Seeley discriminator. So this is the variant of the Foster-Seeley discriminator. You will be able to understand while drawing the diagram what is the difference in this. This is the block diagram of the ratio detector circuit. You can observe in this particular diagram that there is a very slight variation from the Foster-Seeley discriminator. Recall the block diagram which you have drawn in the case of the Foster-Seeley discriminator. This is the block diagram which you have drawn for the phase discriminator or the Foster-Seeley discriminator. Observe this diagram very carefully. What is the direction of diodes, in which particular manner the diodes are connected, where the output is being taken, right? So if you are able to recall this particular diagram, so you will be able to understand about the ratio detector. Now let us understand what is the difference in ratio detector if you compare with the Foster-Seeley. In case of this ratio detector, you can observe total there are three changes. Here the direction of this diode D2 is reversed. In the previous case, in the case of the Foster-Seeley, both the diodes are connected in the same manner, but here the direction of D2 is reversed. Second point, a large value capacitor which is C5, that is being included in the circuit. And third and very important point, here the output is taken at this particular point. Output is taken at somewhere else in comparison to the Foster-Seeley discriminator. So these are the three variations which you must remember over here. And you can see in the case of the ratio detector output, because the output is being taken at this particular point, so output voltage is equal to half of the difference between the output voltages from the individual diode, half of the difference between, if VO1 is the output voltage because of diode D2, VO2 is the output voltage because of the diode D2, this is because of D1, this is because of D2, then the output voltage is equal to the half of difference between these two, right? And it is almost similar to the phase discriminator, that the output voltage is proportional to the difference between the individual output voltage. We have already discussed in the case of the phase discriminator. So in this particular manner, you can say that the operation of ratio detector is almost same as the phase discriminator, and you can explain by taking three different conditions: when Fn is equal to Fc, when F is in between Fc and Fc plus delta F, and the third condition. And accordingly, you can draw the S-shaped curve, which will also be same as in the case of the phase discriminator. But here, the additional feature of ratio detector is amplitude limiting action. So, amplitude limiting action, this is the additional feature in this particular case, which was the drawback of phase discriminator also. So, amplitude limiting action, which is incorporated because of this large value of capacitor C5, and due to this, amplitude limiter is not required prior to the ratio detector. The operation can be performed at this particular end. Now, let us understand amplitude limiting using ratio detector. So, to understand, let us discuss how ratio detector circuit performs responds amplitude changes in the FM signal which is applied to its input. Let us say if the FM input V1, if V1 is the FM input from the amplifier, if this increases, what will happen? It means secondary voltage will also increase. So, upon increasing V1, secondary voltage will also increase, and due to this, the extra diode current means, which is passing through D1 and D2, it will start flowing. It means load current will also increase. So, because of this, load current will increase. It means upon increasing V1, load current increases. But you can observe that the voltage between a point A and B. So, voltage between a point A and B, which is the voltage across the C5 capacitor, this voltage will not change instantaneously. It means it will increase gradually. There is an increase very gradually, right? Now, upon moving further, it means load current has increased. So, when it increases, it means load current increase. So, now let me write that load current increases, but load voltage, which is VAB, this is almost constant. So, when load voltage is constant and load current increases, it means load impedance is effectively decreases. Load impedance effectively decreases because VAB is the constant one. And because of this decreased load impedance, the secondary of input transformer is heavily damped. Secondary of input transformer is heavily damped. Now, because of this damping, Q decreases, and when Q decreases, the gain of amplifier, which is driving the ratio detector, will also decrease. Means, because of this Q decreases, so gain of amplifier will also decrease, and this will counteract the increase in FM input voltage to the ratio detector. Similarly, you can explain the function when the amplitude of FM signal decreases. Here we have discussed when V1 increases. So in a similar manner, you can explain what is going to happen when V1 decreases. So when input voltage decreases, now load impedance will increase. When load impedance will increase, so the damping of input transformer is reduced. When damping of input transformer is reduced, it means in this particular case, the value of Q increases. It means it increases the gain of driving amplifier to compensate the reduction in amplitude. So you can explain that, you can now say that ratio detector provides the amplitude limiting by means of a process known as diode variable damping, which is the diode variable damping. So in this particular manner, it is going to be happen over there. So this is how you can explain the function of the ratio detector. Now, the same phasors as we have drawn in the case of the Foster-Seeley discriminator, the relation between the primary and secondary you can draw. Means from here you can say primary and secondary voltages are exactly 90 degree out of phase when input frequency is FC. It is less than 90 degree out of phase means when FN is higher than FC, and it is more than 90 degree when FN is below FC, means below the carrier frequency. You can plot the frequency response curve of ratio detector also. See, the three different conditions have been taken. When FN is equal to FC, in that particular case, output voltage VO, which is the difference between VO1 minus VO2 divided by 2, that is equal to 0. So you are getting this point. When FC is increased and it is less than FC plus delta F, it is increasing. When FC is like decreasing, you can see the curve over here. So in this particular, you can observe that there is a useful range, linear range in between the two points A and B. This is actually the useful range. Output voltage V0 is being taken on Y-axis, and on X-axis input frequency we have taken. So from its typical shape of the curve, this is also known as a S-curve. And there is a linear portion, which is the useful range, and towards the edges you can see the response is very distorted. There are certain advantages of the ratio detector also. It is very easy to align. This is a major advantage of ratio detector. In this particular case, good linearity is obtained in comparison to the other detectors, and this good linearity is because of the linear phase relationship between the primary and secondary. In case of ratio detector, amplitude limiting is provided inherently. Therefore, there is no additional limiter is required, right? So these are the cases which you must remember. And the ratio detectors are used in TV receivers, sound section, in narrow band FM receivers. So you must remember why it is used and what are the advantages. Thank you so much for watching this video.